Malacanang mom on calls for President Marcos to appoint an agriculture secretary. This comes amid suggestions Marcos, who is concurrent agriculture chief, should pick a full-time secretary if government wants to curtail the alleged cartel behind the sugar crunch in the country. Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles also says Malacanang will not comment on testimonies on the congressional probe into the sugar import mess. Angeles notes they will wait for Congress to complete its investigation. She adds customs agents will continue inspecting sugar warehouses nationwide to check on possible sugar hoarding or smuggling.
The Philippine Social Welfare Department will require online registration in the distribution of educational aid. DSWD Secretary Erwin Tulfo says this is to prevent a repeat of the problematic cash handout last Saturday. Tulfo adds the distribution will be in alphabetical order.
Kunwari, itong darating na Sabado, letter yung mga apelyido na starting with letter A hanggang letter J, sabi niyang ganun, eh papupuntahin natin. Pagkatapos next Saturday na naman, yung letter K hanggang letter P o Q. Ganun ang mangyayari para talagang maayos po. Pero online po muna, online po yung aayusin natin. This time, sir, bababa po namin sa mga lungsod. Merong payout sa Caloocan, may payout sa Quezon City, Manila, Bicitis. And then municipalities po, mayroon pong payout yun sa San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. So para hindi na po sila lalayo.
Over 53,000 indigent students already received educational aid from government over the weekend.
The return of Filipino students to classrooms amid the pandemic has highlighted the need to also ramp up COVID vaccinations in their age group. In response, some local government units set up satellite inoculation sites near schools. Rafael Bosano reports.
After 2 years of studying at home, Annalyn's children are ecstatic to meet their teachers and classmates in person. But before heading to class, they dropped by the satellite vaccination site inside San Juan Elementary School. Annalyn admits she had no time to bring them to a vaccination site prior to school opening, so having one right inside the school compound is very convenient.
Hindi lang excited, pati sila excited na rin. Kasi dati pa nila sinasabi na, Mami, magpabaksin na ako. Sila po talaga ang gustong magbabaksin talaga. Mahirap po magkasakit ngayon kasi dati nga po, nung naglagnat lang, sabihin, may COVID na. Kaya mahirap po talaga. Kailangan mag-ingat talaga, doble-doble.
San Juan Elementary School is just one of the 13 public schools in the city that has its own satellite vaccination site that will be in operation for the next 2 weeks. Mayor Francis Zamora says it's not only the students who can get jabbed in these sites. Annalyn and another household member took advantage of the opportunity by getting their booster shots. In nearby Pinaglabanan Elementary School, the situation is different. There is no queue, but the principal expects a line to form tomorrow.
Ang Pinaglabanan Elementary School ay 100% na po in-person classes. Ang karamihan din po ay bakunado na. May ilan po tayo na hindi bakunado, kaya po hinihikayat ko po sila na magpabakuna na, dahil kung bakunado ka, at least hindi na nag-aalala yung mga teacher na mahawa sila kung ikaw ay carrier, at ganun din yung mga klase nila.
Meanwhile, Camarin High School in Caloocan City, which is said to have one of the highest student population in the country, vaccination sites will also be set up. Aside from thermometers, the school plans to minimize the spread of COVID through staggered mealtimes and physical education classes. Isolation protocols are also in place and backup modules ready just in case. Data from the Department of Health show that more than 9.8 million adolescents aged 12 to 17 years have already received the primary series of a COVID-19 vaccine, while over 4.5 million aged 5 to 11 have received the first two doses. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.